Hi, this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com. And today we're just taking a little trip around the garden to look at some of the pieces of garden art that we have instilled in our garden. This we found at a farmer's market, a local artisan, and it just appealed to us because it reminded Rick of the herons that and the egrets that he likes so well. And even in the winter, it leaves a really neat shadow on the snow, or it looks like he's walking through the snow, so that's neat. And as it rusts, it gets even neater.
Well, what other little pieces, gems have you picked up?
We have a couple more bird ones, but we do have an American flag behind you. Now, we picked up two of these at a rummage sale, and because my dad and Rick's dad and our grandparents and our uncles were all in World War II and World War I,
we decided... I was in World War II or World War I.
Well, and you were in the Vietnam War.
Okay, well, let's give a little credit to that war.
That we would have these. And the neat thing about these is even though they're one piece, they do seem to move with the wind. So we got one in the back and one in the front.
How about your little whirligig here?
And this was another local artist who creates these little whirly, twirly things. These two seem to be the ones that move the most. It takes a really large wind to get this one to go. But they're fun.
I like how the sunlight sometimes bounces right off of those marbles.
Mm-hmm.
Catches your eye. And of course your broken butter or your
dragonfly. Well, I love the solar lights, but this particular kind is really weak where they connect. So we've tried foam
several here
and there's another one over there with a piece of foam, and they still work, they just look crooked. And then these we bought at the dollar store. They've faded quite a bit, but they're fun. This was another, look at all these
cottonwoods
stuck to it. These were from another local artist, bought at the craft part of the farmer's market, which you can tell Rick recently painted, and he painted some of the bridal or bleeding heart the same color.
Well, I wanted them to blend.
Has a big glass ball at the end. But Rick always says this is him and me.
Well, I have to wear a hat to cover my mohawk.
Uh-huh. And you see, I'm patiently listening to him.
Yeah, but look, that's your hairdo right there.
And then that very same artist did these, which bob and twirl. And that's Rick and me talking to each other in a heated discussion.
Twirling around.
One of our very first ones is over on this other side here. So we have
Let's go take a look at that one. How about your sundial?
Oh. This was from my dad's garden. He had this in his yard, and when he passed, this is one of the things that Rick really enjoyed from his garden, so that's where it is now.
Well, plus he gave us the flagpole.
Yes, that's Dad's flagpole.
That way we can honor each member of our family who have actually served in the armed forces. Proud of all of them.
And that's his bird bath over there.
That's right.
Now this was our very first one. It's a whirligig, which turns, and thus the
hummingbird.
The hummingbird is drinking out of the lily. The problem is, while this was constructed very well, it just doesn't sit right and it won't stay level, so that it's always just kind of at the mercy of a high wind.
Well, I know who we're going to talk to fix that for us. American Cottage Industries. What a great, great family-owned business. They can fix anything.
It just needs some kind of washer or bushing or something.
No, we'll have them make a larger pole for us, larger diameter. Or maybe weld a new bottom to it.
Maybe,
who knows?
Maybe that's what it needs. Yeah. And then there are some sculptures from my husband when he decided he would take a welding class just for the fun of it, not for the mechanics of using it in a business like most people would, but for art purposes. And some more wind chimes. Some of them are skies. They sound lovely. He loves the sound of them while he's sleeping. Nice tones. And then up on the roof here.
Up on the roof.
The same neighbor that gave us the duck decoy also gave us these flapping mallards, one of which has now fallen over. But it was fun because it looked like they were taking off. Here's my little quiet garden over here that has a number of little mementos. The pig stepping stone that I got from our daughter Lace, along with the little bird seed feeder. This was a little piece of cement work that we got when Key and Tanya moved into their house and were redoing their backyard that they were nice enough to give us. And then the turtle was a little piece of artwork that Sky found and brought it home. It has a couple of legs missing, but because of how we have it angled against that little stub there, that stump, which also was a gift. That was not a tree that grew anywhere around here. It's from our friend and former neighbor Lee, who brought it from his place up north and thought it would look good in one of our gardens.
Well, it was part of the driftwood that floated up onto his pier.
Ah, that's what it was.
And then he brought you a stone, too.
And then he brought me that lovely stone that is right next to the turtle.
And, of course, you love stone collections.
I do love stones. I have little piles and little
stone sculptures.
Little sculptures here and there and everywhere. And then that little bench that we got from Key and Tanya also. They have a home in Milwaukee, an old home. And at the time they didn't want this little cement bench, so we were lucky enough to get it. I've used it for a table, we've used it for a chair, Logan and I use it for playing games. And then at the varying rummage sales and people's homes, we find different artifacts. I'm guessing this was just a hanging basket of some kind.
Then I noticed you put one of your...
Right, that was a...
trays up there, a little bird bath up
bird
into
bath
the tree.
That Lace gave us. Mm-hmm. And then this little birdhouse we got from our neighbor when she was having a rummage, which we just use as a piece of sculpture. And then...
How about the birdhouse on the house?
Recently, yes, my husband surprised me at a rummage that we were at that had homemade birdhouses. We were at a rummage sale recently where a man had made all these different kinds of just pretty little decorated birdhouses. And this one called to Rick, and so he got it for me as a gift. Now, there are building materials in here. I've seen a little house wren who has been struggling to get pieces of nesting material inside there. And she was working in the top one and kept trying to put the same piece of grass in there, and it would fall and she would pick it up, or to get stuck here and she'd pick it up, and she went in and she tried to pull it in and then it fell on the ground, and then she picked it up and this time she went into the bottom hole and stuck it in there. So I've seen her there several times, but I really don't think she ever actually made a nest. And then this was a bird feeder that Lace gave me for Christmas one year, because that's what I always ask for, that we've had, and because I used to be a teacher, it had to be the Little Red Schoolhouse.
What do you mean, used to be?
And then this is our famous soda bottle bird feeder that the birds enjoyed all last winter. Just marvelously so.
Yeah, you can take any old soda bottle, and it just, and the bird feeder section just screws right on.
Just tips
I think
in.
We got that at American Scientific. I think they're the ones who offer it for sale.
Right. They do have it online, though. I've found it online.
Okay.
And then that beautiful bird feeder over here. And this little finch feeder that my grandson Logan gave me for Christmas this year. And it, I could barely keep it filled. It was so popular with the finches. And the chickadees and the sparrows. It was very popular. I don't have anything in it right now because I figure they're out busy finding bugs and seeds on their own. And then next to our little pond, we have a collection of pebbles and shells from different places that we've visited. Geodes that we have from.
Well, we cut those.
Yep. And ode to when Rick was in Okinawa. We have an oriental fisherman and an incense burner from way back that we thought would look neat.
A little pagoda.
A little pagoda. A little raccoon.
And aren't some of those shells from Florida and California?
Oh, yes. Right. Yep. And Mexico.
Yeah.
And then our neighbor gave us a duck decoy that for years I never even thought to put in. And Rick said, why don't we float this in the pond? So. There he is.
Next to the water lilies. How about your little pig and mailbox?
Yep, those are little,
your little
things
fountain
that either we received as gifts or found at a rubbish. And then our little fountain that we turn on every now and again.
Well, this used to be a three-tiered waterfall.
Yes, it did.
And then when our grandson was born, we felt uncomfortable having water here.
Right, so because it was so close to his level.
I remember the two guys that came and dug all that sludge out. I mean, they were filthy head to toe. They were a mess.
Yep. And then...
How about your glass? Oh, how about your...
My flamingos here.
Yes.
My dad had pink flamingos in his yard, as was the fashion back then. And again, when we were breaking down the family home and he had no more use for them, I said, well, I'll take them, I'll put them in my yard. And so they now live in this little archway. And this is a piece of glass, garden glass, that my sister gave me.
And how about the gargoyles?
And the gargoyles that Sky gave us.
And the talking frog.
Yes, the talking frog that I named Richard. I gave Rick that for his birthday one year, and every time you'd go past it, it had a sensor and it would croak. Ribbit, ribbit.
So you want me to croak?
No, not unless you're going to say ribbit, ribbit.
Oh, okay. And how about the... The history of this one.
Our neighbor across the street had this very, very heavy bird bath, and it developed a crack. But it still held water. She had repaired it at some point. So she was redoing her yard and said, would you like the bird bath? And we said, oh yeah, that'd be great. So Rick brought it home and we set it up and filled it up with water, and it would stay filled with water maybe a quarter of a day, and then it would all leak out. And then sometimes it would stay full for a couple of days. Well, last year in the fall, I decided I am going to patch this so that it lasts and we can have water in it. I went to pick it up, to carry it in, to do the work, and this whole piece crumbled in my hands. And Rick said, oh, just throw it away. We'll just get a new top for it. And I said, no, let me see if I can patch it together. So it is now epoxied, caulked, and cemented. And I brought it out to see how it would work. And darn if it doesn't hold water. Then we put these pieces of sandstone in it, which seems now to have turned everything a nice algae red. But I see by the looks of this that there has been a bird here enjoying it, so I guess it's found its purpose again. This was our original wind chime that we bought years ago. We've restrung Many times.
More than I wish to remember.
And then, whatever possessed Rick, I don't know, he decided we needed a Grecian urn here. So we now have a half of a person with a pot on the top. And it has no drain holes. It's probably the worstly put together planter that anyone would ever sound. It weighs a ton. We got it on sale at the end of the year and he couldn't resist. So it's been with us ever since.
Well, actually, I think it was set up to be a water fountain.
Oh, that could be.
If I remember correctly.
That could be.
But that is a heavy, heavy piece. That's just solid, solid cement.
Mm-hmm.
I would say it probably weighs a good 150 to 200 pounds,
ooh,
maybe more.
Yes. Rick claims that these particular pieces that we now consider art in our garden were cutting exercises so that the people taking the class would get the experience of different gauges and different types of metal, and then they were asked to weld them together, so they got that purpose also. So this is the one that has the heavier gauged metals, and I'm thinking these are representations of grasses on the prairie, perhaps.
No, I thought it was an ode to your hairdo.
No, I didn't even have this hairdo when you were doing that.
Yeah, but that's what inspired me to cut your hair this way.
Ah, and then this one over here is a finer gauge with more spirals to it.
It was fun. I mean, you know, I'd never taken a welding class before, and just cutting was an interesting process. I liked that a lot.
Oh, here, let me pull some weeds while we're here.
You have weeds?
Now, Rick was always afraid having them out here because he thought someone might impale themselves on them, but now that they're surrounded and they're in a place that people shouldn't be traipsing through anyway, I think we're safe. Now, here's a little guy you don't often see sitting so quietly in the daylight. This was one of those owl decoys that people had to scare birds out of their yard so they wouldn't eat their tomatoes or strawberries or whatever, but we just thought he looked really cool up here, and so Sky put him here and anchored him down. Nice glowing eyes. We have one more owl at a different location.
And what are you going to do to the dead tree?
Ah, well, this spring we were at two different events, and we were delighted with some concrete leaf castings, so you have to see what those are.
Okay, sounds good.
And we're doing a fun project today. We're putting in a butterfly hummingbird drinking bath for the fun of it. This one we know is made from a hosta leaf. It's a leaf casting made with cement. They're quite heavy. And this one, I'm not sure what kind of leaf it was, but it's lovely, whatever it is.
And then hand-painted,
and
obviously.
And hand-painted, right. Now, this one we got as a gift, and this one we bought at a church garden fundraiser. Both made by the same woman, Sharon. You know who you are. And we love them so, and we were trying to think of a special place for them. That's when our hibiscus tree decided it wasn't going to be on this earth anymore, but left its skeleton for us. And we thought, well, the birds like to land here, and maybe they would like to have a little bird bath, or the butterflies would, or maybe the hummingbirds.
So you're going to be adding a little garden art.
We are. We definitely are. And let's see. I'm going to try this one. And see if we can just put it in here without trimming anything. See if we can secure it well enough. Oh yeah, that's very secure. That's not going anywhere. It's not going to be very deep, but that's fine because that's what butterflies like. And then other one. No, I think I'm going to put it in here. Don't you think, Rick?
I think somewhere. So. I think you're going to have to do a little trimming in there to get it to work, though.
Yep, I think I'm going to have to get the loppers.
Okay.
Okay, well, I'm going to try experimenting here, and I'm going to take this one off right here.
Just don't cut your finger. And that would take your finger off.
Yes, it would.
Well, try it. See if you have to take another one out.
Yep, somebody else has to go.
Okay, and probably this one right here.
This one or this one?
No, I would start with this one at the same level. Using my artistic eye.
That look about even?
Yep. There you go.
Yep, your artistic eye was right. There we go. Now this one has a hole right here, so only these little crevices are going to be holding water. And we're not concerned about mosquitoes either in these or in our bird baths, because we pretty much empty them and refill them every few days.
Well, get a little hose and let's see what you can do.
I like it. They don't hold much, but they sure are cute. They look a lot better than just having this tree with no purpose but birds standing. I hope you enjoyed our garden art tour, and I encourage you to go to not only rummage sales, but also to Goodwill, Purple Heart, Salvation Army. Even look in your house for little things that maybe you wouldn't think would be in a garden. But when you get them out there, they just look so perfect. Little teacups that have seeds in them, or pieces of glass that you never thought, why would you put it outside? But when it gets out in the sun, it looks gorgeous. And be sure then to think of other people who have gardens that might like to find a little treasure as they're looking around in their flowers and suddenly see a little elf house or some surprise that maybe they weren't expecting. So if you enjoyed the video, please give us a thumbs up. Love to hear from you, and enjoy working in your garden and enjoy other people's gardens as well.
Well, I suppose these steel rims would count as garden art.
Oh, they would. Yes, you're right.
I mean, these are off railroad trains,
right.
The big old
the
steel
tanker.
Wheels.
Right.
You know, who would have thought of using those in the garden?
Who would have thought? So, it doesn't have to be your traditional flamingo in the garden. It could be most anything. As
there
long as you find pleasure in it, put it outside and enjoy it outside too. Bye for now.
Any butterflies yet?
Not yet.
Hummingbirds?
Not yet.